3 feet by 3 feet. So this is the size of footing. Okay. Assalamu alaikum guys, welcome back to Civil Engineers YouTube channel. Today in this important video lecture, I will guide you for size of RCC footing and its steel reinforcement details, as well as size of column and its steel reinforcement for ground floor domestic building, not for commercial or other type of building. That's why, because many students, they comments in comments box and they are asking what should be the minimum and maximum size of footing for ground floor house. So let's get started guys. First of all, I will tell you guys size of footing at steel reinforcement and size of column and steel reinforcement is depend on the structure load. That what is the structure load or self load of different materials. Okay, so from that you can calculate. But nowadays many people, they are working without steel structural design. Okay, so therefore they need just some guidance, okay, to design their to start their small construction. So therefore I will recommend you some important points which can help you during construction work. So guys, you can see this is the footing plan. Okay, so what should be the maximum size for ground floor and minimum size of ground floor for just for ground floor, not for one two story or three story, etc. Okay guys, here you can see this is size. So the maximum and minimum size of the footing. Okay, so footing. Okay, so the footing size should be maximum size. Okay, footing maximum size should be 3.5 feet. Okay, for square. So 3.5 by 3.5 feet, right? But the minimum should be 2 by 2 feet for ground floor. Okay, the minimum should be 2 by 2 and maximum should be 3.5 by 3.5. But I recommend you for ground floor house, you can take the size of the footing 3 feet by 3 feet. So this is the size of footing. Okay, now come to its steel reinforcement guys. So steel reinforcement dia should be, okay, so now diameter of steel, dia of steel rods. Okay, remember for normal residential, the size or the dia of steel reinforcement should be minimum 12 mm. Sorry, not minimum. Okay, so normally you can use 12 mm dia. The dia should be 12 mm, and normal, but the minimum should not be less than 10 mm. Okay, so this is normal. Okay, so minimum should be 10 mm. Okay, now its spacing. Okay, it should not be more than 150 mm center to center, and also for 10 mm should be 150 mm center to center distance between two steel rods, as you can see here. So this steel dia should be 12 mm with the spacing of 150 mm. Okay, so this is one is distribution and the other one is main bar. Okay, you can see this is main bar, for example. So also it should be 12 mm with the spacing of 150 mm. Right, so these are its steel reinforcement. Now guys, on each side the concrete cover should be, as you can see now I'm making a section. Okay, so at the bottom, okay, minimum do lean concrete. Okay, with that is with the thickness of 150 mm. Okay, or 6 inches. So this should be the PCC, plain cement concrete PCC, and the ratio of this PCC should be 1:4:8. One part is cement, 4 part is sand, and 8 parts are aggregate. Okay, so 1:4:8. But here guys, remember that extra concrete cover should be taken minimum 40 mm on each side. 40 mm. Okay, on four sides, also at the top, at the bottom, at the sides, okay? So the concrete should be 40 millimeter concrete cover. Now guys, come to its steel reinforcement, especially for column. So this is footing. So the second one is, guys, column details. Okay, so for normal residential building, just for ground floor, the size of the column should not be less than 9 by 9 inches. Size should not be less than 9 by 9 inches. So I saw in most of the construction, many people, they are using the size of the column 6 by 6 inches, guys. So it cannot work. Okay, so you will face more problems because it cannot expensive. So it is also cheap, size of the column 9 by 9 inches, but use minimum here 4 steel rods. Okay, so use minimum 4 steel rods inside the column. And the dia of the column, the longitudinal bar should not be less than 12 millimeter. Not less than 12 millimeter. But guys, you can see it's lateral tie. So you can see now this is lateral tie. So the lateral tie die should not be less than 6 millimeter for normal residential building. Now guys, you can see the hooks. So these hooks length should not be less than 3 inches. 3 inches are 9D, where D is the die of this steel. Got it? So this is very important to do this kind of shape, and this angle should not be so it should be on 135 degree. But in most of the construction, as I told you in many videos, practical, when I visit to any construction site, so you can see nowadays the angle, so these hooks are bent with 90 degrees. So guys, it's wrong. It cannot resist with earthquake. So therefore, as you can see, like this, on 90 degree they are providing. So guys, this is wrong. So it should be provided same like this, as you can see here, 135 degree. So this is okay, right? So these are steel reinforcement. Now guys, you can see from the top of, so this is column, so use minimum 4 steel rods. But when you increase 6 steel rods, so it will be better, okay? But you can use the extra bars, which dia should be also, you can take on about 10 mm, okay, also. But the main longitudinal bar dia should not be less than, in the column, 12 millimeter, okay? Now guys, let me discuss its lateral ties details, okay? So you can see this is the column, and these are lateral ties, okay? So the spacing of lateral ties should not be less than 150 mm, okay? Sorry, it should not be less than 100 mm, okay? About, you can see, 4 inches. But here at the bottom and also at the top, it should be, try to use with 4 inches, but at the mid you can increase up to the 150 mm, okay? 150 mm center to center distance. This is the other important point. Now if you want to provide the lapping, okay, so at the lapping, the lateral ties should be closely about 3 to 4 inches, but don't increase it, okay? But normally you can see the distance between two lateral ties up to 6 inches. Now guys, you can see at the top, so these are, you can see the legs, okay? On the footing we can provide. So these legs length should not be less than 12 inches. Minimum it should be 12 inches. But normally you can keep up to the 18 inches, okay? So guys, this is the very important topic which I have discussed upon the view. But sorry guys, what should be the minimum size? So the minimum size of the footing should not be less than 2 by 2 feet, 24 by 24 inches, okay? So hope this will be clear. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.